CBS News producer and talent executive Maria Mercator died of COVID-19 in New York Sunday, CBS said. She was 54. Mercator worked at CBS for 3 decades, getting her start in the network's Page program, CBS said in a release. She most recently worked as a director of talent strategy. She had been on medical leave for an unrelated matter since late February, the network said. Mercator courageously fought cancer and related illnesses for 20 years, enduring numerous treatments and surgeries, CBS said. To her colleagues and family, she was an inspiration and a symbol of hope each time she returned to work after the latest medical setback threatened to end her life. As a producer on CBS News' foreign and national desks, Mercator helped produce coverage of some of the biggest breaking news, including the death of Princess Diana and the 9/11 attacks, the release said. A hard hit to the heart, News' longtime colleague and friend Maria Mercator died from coronavirus, tweeted former CBS News anchor Dan Rather. A paragon of grit and grace, she embodied the best of the CBS News mission. Millions of Americans learned of the world through her efforts. Now our world is less with her loss. R.I.P. In 2004, Mercator won an Emmy for business and financial reporting for her work producing a CBS Sunday morning report on computer spam. As a talent executive, Mercator helped spearhead the network's efforts to diversify its workforce, CBS said. Maria was a friend to all, said Lori Orlando, senior vice president for talent at CBS News. It's nearly impossible to be someone everyone loves, but Maria was. She always had a warm hug, a word of advice or support, and a big smile for everyone in her life. She was a bright light and will be sorely missed. A woman got to say goodbye to her mother over FaceTime before she died thanks to a nurse at this Washington hospital. Michelle Bennett didn't think she'd be able to say goodbye to her mother before she died. Like a lot of families across the country right now, Bennett was told she couldn't be in the same vicinity as her 75-year-old mother, Carol Ann Christine Gann, who had contracted coronavirus and was nearing the end of her life. Not being able to be there and hold my mom's hand, rub her head, tell her the things I wanted to say to her. It was such a helpless feeling. I can just remember the days leading up feeling so frustrated and helpless and not being able to talk to her because she was not conscious during that time, Bennett told CNN Monday. But a nurse at Swedish Asakwa Hospital in Washington took it upon herself to make sure Bennett got to say her goodbyes. Bennett told CNN the nurse called her from her personal cell phone and said her mother's breathing was changing and she probably wouldn't live much longer. I'm going to put the phone up to her face so you can tell her you love her and say your goodbyes, Bennett says the nurse told her. She will not be alone, we will stay with her till the end. 10 minutes later, Bennett says she was speaking to her ailing mother over FaceTime. I love you very much, Bennett told her mother, adding the two had discussed recently the trials every mother-daughter relationship goes through and that she never got to tell her mother she forgave her. I forgive you, Mom, I love you. I know I didn't get a chance to say it, Bennett said. She admitted it was tough expressing her feelings when she wasn't actually there, but she hopes her mother heard her last words. Mom, it's okay to pass on. It's okay to go now. Within an hour, Bennett said she was gone. Bennett said she saw the nurse was crying as she took the phone away. I know how difficult this is for them, she said. I can't imagine being on the front lines of that and having to go home every day and risk infection themselves, but then have the compassion and the empathy to be right there in that moment as if it was their own mother. That was one of the most amazing things I've experienced.